Now you can see here, work area is there, work area customer. I am double clicking. Each and every field is filled now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 20, 7, 20, Bangalore, like that. It is filling. Now append statement came here.
So please share the screen.
Oh, sorry, I did. 1 minute, I will. Okay, now is it okay?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Now here work area is there. I'm double clicking on this work area. So each and every field is filling here. Four columns are there, mean four fields are there. Four fields are filling the work area. Now I will come to internal table. Internal table here, 0 into 4 is there. Okay, we have to observe this one. 0 into 4. Okay, if I double click on this customer, nothing is there. Okay, now the cursor is at append statement. Okay, 25th line. Okay, the line is not executed yet. If I click on F5 button, okay, if I click on F5 button, then this line will execute. Then we have to observe this one. 0 into 4 is there. Okay, the value will change here. Okay, I am clicking on F5 button. See, 1 into 4 came. Okay, 1 into 4. You can double click on this internal table. See, one record is inserted here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, something name. Okay, one record is inserted here. Click on back. Okay, now I am filling the second record. Okay, I am filling the second record of work area. So second name is, see, already the data is there. Okay, already something name is, something data is available in this work area. Okay, I am overwriting. Okay, already name Gayatri is there. In place of Gayatri, I am passing the Balaji. Okay, I am overwriting the name. Okay, click on F5 button. You can observe here. Okay, you can observe the values, how the values are changing. Okay, now click on F5 button. Okay, see, the in place of Gayatri, Balaji is coming. Okay, now the number is 1, 2, 3, 4 here. Here the number is 1, 2, 3, 5. Okay, click on F5 button. See, 1, 2, 3, 5 changing here. Okay, next document date. Document date, how it is coming? Here 10.7.2020, like that it is coming. Okay, next, here Bangalore is there. And here Hyderabad is there. Okay, click on F5 button. See, it is changing to Hyderabad now. Okay, if you double click on this customer, you can see all the data at the place. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 5, Balaji, date and address. Now append statement came. Okay, append statement means I am moving something data to internal table. Okay, here 1 into 4 is there. Okay, one record is there, four columns are there. Okay, one record only, four columns. Now I will click on F5 button. You can see 2 into 4 means two records are available. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3, 5. Two records are available, but four columns are there. Okay, I'm clicking on back. Same thing. Click on F5. Okay, if I click on F5 button, there is no executable statements. It will go to standard programs. Okay, already two records are available. If I click on F5 button, the third record also will move to internal table, but we cannot see that one because after 38 line there is no executable line. That is why we cannot see here. Automatically it will go to some standard programs, or the standard program is coming here. Okay, this is not required. So click on F8 button, last button. I'm closing this one. Why it is coming, I will let you know later. Okay, there is no exact, I mean, we are not displaying anything, we are not doing anything here. Okay, otherwise you can click on back button of the program. Then also it is like that only. Stop the transaction here. Close this one. Click on change button. Okay, here this is okay, fine. Okay, I am filling the data in the internal table, that is okay. Now whatever I am filling the data in the internal table, I want to display the data. Okay, I am filling something data in the internal table. Now I want to display the data. How can I display? Okay, so if you want to display the data, then also line by line. Okay. If you want to fill the data, then also line by line. If you want to change the data, then also line by line. If you want to display the data, then also line by line. Line by line only possible in the internal table. Okay, you have to remember that one. Line by line, only one line we can access at a time. Okay. Total, how many records are there? Total, 3 records are there in the internal table. All right. So now we have to read each and every line. Okay, we have to read each and every line, and we have to display the data. Okay, so more than one line is there. More than one line is there. So we have to go for one statement loop. Okay, loop. Loop in loop is coming here. Okay, looper. So which internal table we are looping here? So the internal table name is IT customer. Okay. Internal table name is IT customer. Okay, fine. I am looping this internal table. That is okay. But I have to. I am reading first record. Okay, I am reading first record, and where I am keeping. Okay, I have to keep that one into work area. Okay, here 4 records are coming. Okay, 4 records are coming. So first line I will read. Okay, first line I will read. I have to display this one, right? So first line I am reading. That is okay. But where I have to keep this data? Once again, I have to move this data to work area. Okay, internal table to work area. I am passing the data here. Okay, from this work area, I can display the data. Okay, directly internal table, that is not possible. Okay, that is possible in the report level. Okay, so RISIF is our concept, right? RISIF W, right? So report concept is there. So at that place, so we have some types of reports: internal, classical report, and ALV report like that. Okay, so at that place, that is possible, and up to that time, okay, up to that time, we have to display the data in this way only. There is no another way. Okay, and here internal table is there. I am looping the data. Means first record will come. First record will move to work area. From this work area, I will display the data. Okay, so let us see. In the debugging, you can understand. I think. Okay, looper internal table into work area customer means the first line of this internal table will come to work area. Okay, now I will display the data. How can we display the data? How can we display the data? Anyone? If you want to display, sorry,
right?
Yes, by using write statement. Okay, thank you. So write statement is there. Okay, write statement is there to display the data. So here I am taking a semicolon. Okay, means chain operator I am using here. Chain operator. Okay, now I want to display work area customer hyphen customer number. Okay, and comma I am taking work area customer hyphen customer name. Comma work area customer hyphen document date, comma work area customer hyphen address. Okay, I am keeping here dot. Okay, so you can take like this. Okay, so we have to follow some standards here, right? So I am doing like this. Okay, if you keep all the variables, all the fields in a single line, then what will happen? The debugging level we cannot see. I will show you that one also. Okay, so this is also fine, no problem. Okay, this is also fine, no problem. Now what will happen? Total 3 records are available, right? In this internal table, 3 records are available. So I am looping the internal table. Okay, I am looping the internal table. First of all, it will go to first record. It will move the data to work area, and I am displaying the data from work area. Okay, once again it will come to second record. Okay, once again it will come to second record. Looping means how many records are available, that many of times it will loop here. Okay, first record, second record, third record, fourth record. Okay, how many records are there, that many of times it will loop here. Okay, I will show you in the debugging, then you can understand this one. Okay, now save the program, check the program, and activate the program. So up to here, you know how it is coming. Okay, how the work area is filling, how the internal table is filling. So you know up to here. Okay, I just keep the breakpoint at 39 line and execute the program. Okay, I'm double clicking on internal table IT customer. Okay, and click on desktop preview. Okay, IT customer, three records are coming. You can double click on the internal table. Okay, three records are coming. Okay, now clicking on back button. Okay, and I am double clicking on customer, I mean work area customer also. So if you see here, 1236 Krishna something is coming. So how it is coming here? Previous line. Okay, in the 37 line. Okay, in the 37 line, I am passing the data from work area to internal table. Okay, so in this work area, Krishna 1236 something date is there and Chennai is there. Okay, so this date. Okay, this information is saving in this work area. Okay, no problem. It will overwrite here. Okay, now 39 line came. 39 line. Okay, and if you click on F5 button. Okay, if you click on F5 button, then what will happen? Just see. See here, it came to 40 line. Okay, now if you double click on this work area customer, so how the data is coming? 1234 Gayatri and something name is coming. Okay, so Gayatri is available in the internal table, the first line. See here, first line. And you can see the number also, SY-tabX is there. Okay, in the top, you can see SY-tabX. Okay, so here one is coming. What is the meaning of this one? So in the looping statement, we are in first line. Okay, in the looping statement, we are in first line. Okay, and here F40 is coming. Click on F5 button. Okay, so it will display. Okay, it will display. If the total loop is completed, after that one it will display. Okay, so I am displaying first record. Okay, I am displaying first record from work area customer. Click on F5 button. If I click on F5 button, then what will happen? The cursor is at 41 line. Okay, the cursor is at 41 line. If I click on F5 button, then what will happen? See, once again, the cursor is coming to 39 line. Okay, once again, it is coming to 39. Why it is coming like that? Okay, in the internal table, three lines are there. Okay, three lines are there, but first line only looped here. Okay, remaining two lines are there. Okay, now click on F5 button. See here, the cursor came at 40 line. And you can see here SY-tabX. SY-tabX equal to 2 means, so in the looping, we are in second line. Okay, in the internal table, we are at second line. Okay, you can check here 1235 Balaji is there. Name is Balaji. In the internal table, just open the internal table here. What is the second record? Second record is 1235 Balaji only. Okay, so this data is moved to work area now. Okay, in the write statement, I am displaying the work area information. Okay, once again, click on F5 button. It came to end loop. Okay, so if I click on F5 button, where it will come? It will go to 39 line because the records are not completed yet. Okay, three records are available, but two records only looped here. Okay, click on F5 button. See, the cursor came at 39 line. 39. Click on F5 button. See, you can see here SY-tabX value. Okay, SY-tabX equal to 3 means we are in third line of the internal table. Okay, so here 1236 Krishna is there. Okay, if you double click on the internal table, what is the third record? Third record is 1236 Krishna only. Okay, so in this way, line by line, we can change the data, or line by line, we can insert the data in the internal table. Okay, line by line only is possible in the internal table. Okay, now click on F5 button. End loop came. Okay, end loop came. Now I am clicking on F5 button. If I click on F5 button, then where it will go? Just click on it once. See, once again it came to 39 line. Okay, once again it came to 39 line. Why it came to 39 line once again? Okay, here system doesn't know how many records are available in this internal table. Okay, system doesn't know how many records are available in this internal table. See, SY-tabX equal to 3. Okay, three lines completed. If I click on F5 button, then it will go to next line. Okay, so it will check next line is available or not. Okay, it will check next line is available or not. In this internal table, three lines are completed. Okay, so now if I click an F5 button, it will go to fourth line. If the fourth line is available, it will go inside. Okay, inside the loop. Okay, if the fourth line is not available, okay, the fourth line is not available, then it will come outside. Click an F5 button. Where it is coming? It is coming to 41 line. Okay, 41 line, because here in this internal table only three records are available. Okay, already three records are looped here. Okay, fourth time also it went to the loop here. It is checking, is there any another line like that? Okay, there is no another line. There is no another line. That is why the cursor is coming to 41 line. Okay, and you can see here something symbol here. Okay, something symbol means the looping statement is completed here. It is coming outside of the looping. Okay, the symbol of this one. Okay, yellow symbol, yellow mark is there. That is the cursor is at 41 line. Okay, so and the below black arrow mark is coming, means looping statement is completed here. Okay, we are coming outside of this looping statement. Okay, now click on F5 button. So if you it is generating a standard program. Okay, it is generating some standard program to display the data. So in this case, we have to click on F7 button. Okay, why we have to click on F7 only, we will discuss it later. Okay, F7 and F8, F6, these three things, some functionalities there, I will discuss it later. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, Gayatri, something great, Bangalore, and 1, 2, 3, 5, Balaji, something great, Hyderabad, and 1, 2, 3, 6, it is coming like this. But I don't want like this. Okay, see, first row, I want to display in the first line, second row, second line, third row, third line. Okay, how the internal table data is coming, in that way I want to display the data. Okay, so here Bangalore is coming, so here one record is completed. Okay, Bangalore is coming, here one record is completed. Now I want to skip to second line. Okay, I want to skip to second line. So this is the second record, 1 2 3 5 is the second record. Okay, so this data I want to skip into the second line. I want to move that one to second line. How can we do? Here write statement is coming and chain operator also you are using here. Okay, write statement and chain operator. Okay, if you don't write chain operator, if you don't write semicolon, then what will happen? We have to write here customer number is coming here. Okay, after customer name is coming, for this customer name also we have to write statement, for customer date also we have to write statement, for address also we have to write statement. Instead of that one, we are writing some chain operator. Okay, semicolon we are using, and after that one we have to pass slash. Okay, forward slash is coming here. You just pass the forward slash, then what will happen? Okay, first of all it will display customer number, customer name, document date and address. Okay, four columns it will display. Okay, it will come to the next end loop. Okay, end loop, and once again it will come to the loop here. Okay, and it will come to the write statement. At that time it will skip to second line. Okay, now you can see the output, how it will come. Activating the program and execute the program, see how it is coming. Okay, line by line the data is coming here. Okay, if you remove this one, this forward slash, okay, then activate the program, execute the program, see how it is coming here. Okay, the data is coming horizontally. Okay, there is no break here. Okay, we are not skipping at any place. So we have to provide here slash. Okay, so in this way we can create the internal table and work area. Okay, so this is the internal table, right? This internal table will not work outside of the program. This will work in this program only. Okay, in this program only. It won't work outside of the program. This is the temporary data. Okay, this is the temporary data. Whenever you execute line by line 21, 22, 23 and 25, at that time only the data is filling in the internal table. Okay, at that time only the data is filling in the internal table. okay, and they may ask you in interview, they may ask you what is the difference between internal table and normal table. Okay, so in normal table means SE11 table. Okay, we can save the data permanently in the normal table, database table, SE11 table. Okay, but we cannot save the data permanently in the internal table. Okay, so database table is there, SE11 table is there. We can use the table anywhere in our SAP. Okay, we can use the table anywhere in our SAP. But internal table is there. Internal table is available in that program only. Okay, in that program only. If you come outside, okay, if you come outside of the table, then it won't work here. Okay, so in this way we can fill the internal table line by line, we can fill the data. Okay, now my requirement is, I want to fetch, okay, I want to fetch something data from table level. Okay, here VBAK something data is there, right? The here VBAK means sales information. You have to remember some table names. Okay, here VBAK is coming. Okay, VBAK means sales header data. Okay, sales header data. So whatever I am spelling here, you have to apply that one in your real life. Okay, sales information. Okay, for example, if you have any company, okay, you are managing one company, okay, something customer will order something material, you are delivering, okay, you have to dispatch that material to the customer. Okay, at that place we have to create one sales order. Okay, in the sales order we have to maintain customer number, customer name, customer address, so what is the material he has ordered. Okay, this all information we are maintaining. Okay, this is one sales order. Okay, sales order. Okay, this information will store in VBAK table. Okay, this is the header data. Okay, if you want item data, then VBAP is the item data for sales. Okay, yesterday we discussed about T001 company code information. Okay, we have to remember few tables. Okay, not all tables, some hundreds, some thousands of tables will be there in SAP. Okay, we cannot remember all the tables, but minimum tables we have to remember. Okay, 20, 30, like that tables we have to remember. Okay, in our daily life we will use these tables. Okay, T001 is there, we will use that one frequently. Okay, and VBAK sales information table, VBAP sales item table. Okay, frequently we will use this one. And KNA1 customer information, and LFA1 vendor information, like that some tables are there. So daily I will tell one table, two tables, like that you just remember the tables. So what is the use of that one, which type of information to be stored in the table you have to remember. Okay, now my requirement is, see, something sales document and something data is there here, right? So this information, okay, this information I want to pick. Okay, I want to pick this information and I want to display in our program. Okay, I want to pick from this table and I want to display in our program level. Okay, how can we do? This is for sales information. Okay, executable program, and the package name is JDJF I'm giving, and it will ask the request, right? I will create one more request here. So create request, sales information. Okay, click on save button. See, automatically it is raising, it is generating one request. Okay, request is nothing but TR, transport request. Okay, click on OK button. Okay, here we have to maintain, okay, who is creating, when it is created, who is the functional for this one. Okay, and what is the package for this one, first time, what is the tier generated for this one. These all information we have to maintain the comments the beginning of the report. Okay, that is mandatory thing in our real time. Okay, as of now I am not maintaining, but you have to maintain in your practice session. Report is coming, fine. Now I have to declare, okay, I have to declare one internal table or one work area. Okay, how can we declare? So sales information is coming from VBAK table, right? So I will click on back button. I don't want all data. Okay, I don't want all the things, just I want sales document number. Okay, sales document number and document type. Okay, so as of now you don't know what is this sales document type and a few fields. Okay, by going in further classes you can understand what is this document type like that. Whenever you get to know about life cycle of SD, sales and distribution module, then you can get to know. Okay, Kunal sold to party there. Okay, I will take a few fields from the VBAK table. I will tell you. Okay, here I am declaring my work area. How can we declare? Data, beginner, work area. This is a sales order. Okay, sales order. So I am taking WA_SO. Okay, by seeing of that naming we can easily understand WA is there, this is work area, and SO is there, sales order. Okay, by seeing of that name we can easily understand. Okay, here VBELN type. See here, the VBAK table, sales document number. Okay, if you purchase something from the Flipkart or Amazon, at that time they will give you one document like invoice. Okay, you can see invoice also. Okay, in the invoice they will maintain one invoice number. Okay, if they pass the invoice number they can get to know all the information. The same way here also sales document number. Okay, sales document number. The what is the field name here? VBELN. Okay, VBELN is the sales document number in the VBAK table. Okay, what is the type and length? Type is character and length is 10. Okay, whatever the type and length is there. Okay, whatever the type and length is there, same type and length also we have to declare here. Okay, type C of 10. Okay, beginner, work area, and here VBELN. Okay, VBELN is a field name here, and type is character and length is 10. Same thing I am taking here. Okay, character and type length is 10. Or so what is this Kunal here? Just check here, control F. Okay, so if you want to find any field, then control F is there, shortcut key. Otherwise you can click on this find symbol. Okay, I want to know customer. Okay, KUNNR is coming. Okay, KUNNR here, sold to party is coming. Sold to party or ship to party or customer number, all are same here. Okay, sold to party means to whom we are selling the product. Okay, to whom we are selling the product, so we can call as customer also. Okay, sold to party Kunal, customer is the character 10. Okay, character 10, that is why I am declaring here character and 10 is the length. Okay, and document type also is available here, right? Okay, and AUART. Okay, AUART, the document type is character and length is 4. Okay, I am taking that one also. Character 4. Okay, AUART is coming, character 4. Okay, fine. Now, what is the net value? Okay, so in this sales, for these sales order, what is the amount? Okay, you are purchasing something material, something mobile phone or something you are purchasing from Flipkart or Amazon. At that time, they will give you invoice at the last how much the cost for that one, for delivering, for delivery charges and any deductions are there. So after going all the things, how much total amount we have to pay? That amount will store in net value. Okay, NETWR. Okay, what is the data type for this one? Currency, CURR. Okay, and length is 15 here. Okay, and decimal. Okay, 2 is the decimal. After 15 numbers, I want to display 2 digits. Okay, so how can we? So in this way, we can declare, right? Directly we are declaring here. Okay, and now I will declare one more way also. NETWR. Okay, NETWR. NETWR is coming here. Data element is there. Okay, data element. Okay, I can declare one variable by using this data element also. I am copying the data element here. Okay, and I am pasting here. Okay, so here I am directly declaring. Okay, BBLN opt-in type C. Okay, directly data type and length I am giving directly, and here I am giving data element. Okay, so what is the data element? Anyone have idea? What is the data element?
It contains data type.
Sorry.
Collection of charges is the domain.
Yes. What is the domain here?
Data
description.
Yes. 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 Thank you. Thank you. See, I am providing here data element. Okay, data element is nothing but the collection of short description plus domain. Okay, so domain means in the domain we have to maintain the data type and length. Okay, automatically whatever the data type and length is available here. Okay, in this data element, those data type and length will apply for this NETWR. Okay, and one more way. Just I will take something distribution channel, something I am taking. Okay, VTWEG, something distribution channel. Okay, something fill I am taking here. Okay, this is the field name here and type. Okay, so if you want, you can declare in the direct also by giving data type and length or data element. Okay, instead of giving data type and length, I am giving the data element. Okay, but I don't know the data element. Okay, I don't know the data element for this VTWEZ field in the VBAK table. Okay, so in this VBAK table, VTWEZ is there. Okay, here VTWEZ is the data element, but I don't know. Okay, once again, I have to open this VBAK table and I have to search for VTWEZ. And I have to copy this data element, right? So instead of that one, okay, instead of that one, what I will do, I will take here table name directly. Okay, table name is VBAK hyphen, what is the field name for this one? VTWEZ. Okay, table name hyphen field name. Okay, if I take like this, then what will happen? What is the data element for this field? Directly it will go to table. Okay, in backend directly it will go to this table VBAK and it will go to the field name. What is the data element for this one? Okay, what is the data element for this field? That data element will apply here. Okay, that data element will apply. Data element means it will contain the description plus domain. Domain means it will contain the data type and length. Okay, automatically it will come the data type and length. End of work area underscore SO. Okay, directly we can declare, or by giving data element we can declare, and by using table name hyphen field name. Okay, table name hyphen field name. So in this way we can declare. Okay, you can declare any way. There is no wrong way. Okay, all are correct only. Okay, maximum we will go like this. Okay, maximum we will go like this. Table name hyphen field name, because each and every time we can't go the table and we cannot search the field name. What is the data element and we have to copy that one and we have to paste in the program level. Okay, we cannot do that one frequently. Okay, so in our real time we can use some 30 fields or 40 fields from different tables. At that time, each and every time 40 times we have to go to different tables and we have to copy data elements and we have to paste in our program level. But that is not good here. Okay, that is why I will give the table name hyphen field name automatically in the back end. It will go to the table and it will check the field name. What is the data element is applied for that one? That data element will apply here. Okay. Now I will declare internal table data. ITSO. Like table of work area SO. Okay, data ITSO like table of SO. Now one internal table also is declared here. Okay, and tomorrow I will continue this class because the class will disconnect in 2 minutes only, two and a half minute only. Okay, tomorrow I will show you how can we fetch the data from the VBAK table. Okay, how can we pick the data from VBAK table and we have to display the data in our program level. Okay, how can we display the data? Tomorrow we will discuss. And anyone have doubt up to here? Anyone have doubt? Okay, fine. How can we fill the data in the internal table? Anyone? How can we fill the data in the internal table?
By using append statement.
Yes, by using append statement, and we have to save line by line in the internal table. Okay, what is the difference between? Sorry, someone is asking question. Rahim, are you asking anything? Okay. What is the difference between include structure and append structure? Anyone?
Sir, include structure by using of dot include directly include, sir. By customized tables also include also using, sir. By using of append structure only for appending to the standard table, sir.
Append for standard table only, but include append for standard table as well as custom table also. But include is only for custom table. Okay, good.
Custom table. And include using for any position, sir. But append structure append only
at the end of the table.
At the table. End of the.
See, today's scenario, today's assignment is you have to declare one internal table and work area. You have to fill that one, and you have to display the data. Okay, creation of internal table, work area, and display.